In their second interface with the Ugandan National Roads Authority, the issue of delays in compensation of the project-affected persons was a center of interest. The Auditor General's report revealed that UNRA obtained a total of 28,960 acres from 172,608 project-affected persons at 3.2 billion shillings, but only 139,933 project-affected persons were paid 2.5 million shillings for 22,383 acres, leaving 32,675 project-affected persons outstanding. The committee chaired by the Busiro East legislator Medard Lubega Segona discovered that UNRA is in total breach of the constitution by acquiring people's land without prior compensation.
Is under your policy and even the constitution. Article 26 speaks for itself. You do not commence civil works before paying. Now you are saying you have started paying long after completing or taking over people's land. You are in breach of the constitution. And you know the person in breach of the constitution is a rebel.
Deadlines for compensation for compulsory acquisition issued by Ministry of Lands does state that after that period, there should be a reassessment.
Everybody has already been involved in the process. He may not even be biased, but his hands are tied. He's functed as official. He has already burnt his fingers by saying, I approve this valuation.
The Auditor General's report indicated that no project-affected persons were paid for Jinja Mbulamuti, Chenjo Joramanja, and Toro Busia Road projects. UNRA blamed delayed compensation to inadequate funding by the government, which impairs prompt payments.
True, we should be paying the landowners before we start works. But as we talked yesterday, funds are never available. So what do? We engage the landowners, those who are willing to give us land, after valuing and accepting and disclosing, they give us land.
UNRA is also on spot over delays to return land titles of the project-affected persons after the required subdivisions and mutations. The audit report revealed that by November 2023, only 1,428 land titles had been returned to the owners, out of 8,101 land titles obtained from project-affected persons, which fetched the entity in multiple litigations.
To bring your title of somebody who gave you his title, you chopped off yours, did not return his. By the time he went back to do a search, what remained as his title is another person's name.
You know, having after more than 6 acres in the municipality, from that time, the man had been compensated, but the title up today, he has pushed and no response.
What explanation is being given as why these titles have delayed in land office up to now?
Give these land titles and we forward them to Ministry of Land.
Edward Cheswa, a resident of Mukono, is a victim of the delayed release of land titles. His land title has been with UNRA for over 10 years. He has been chasing shadows since 2014.
And that the money given to him was less. He borrowed money, from what he told me. He borrowed money and engaged a private surveyor who issued a report on 22nd August 2022. It was received on 13th January 2023. By UNRA, you have never given him a response.
That Mr. Cheswa Edward was paid 23 million last year in March.
Twala value report jibantuma yangi ngafinye value wangi. Why to mwezi gumu senti ni baziteka kwa account zinaina gani da ngasiri saini nze.
Meanwhile, the Parliamentary Public Accounts Committee has summoned the Commissioner in Charge of Civil Service College Uganda in Jinja to explain failure to collect 523 million shillings from training fees, which was estimated to be collected in the financial year 2022 2023. That decision was informed by a revelation of the Auditor General's report, which quoted underperformance of non-tax revenue collections. The Auditor General's report for the financial year that ended June 2023 revealed that 16 outputs with 131 activities worth 12 billion shillings were partially implemented. Of the 131 activities, 44 activities were partially implemented, while 24 activities remained unimplemented. Unimplemented activities include rollout of electronic management systems in government agencies, training and development for public officers, investigative inspections, among others. The committee tasked officials to account for funds that were allocated and implemented items.
You are not denying that you received the money. The issue is that monies were released and activities were not undertaken. This is what it means precisely.
Legislators also expressed concerns that failure to implement planned activities denies the public access to service delivery.
They did not implement the following planned activities despite having received the required funds. So this answer, as the vice chair said, is too casual.
Failure to fully implement activities was attributed to inadequate funding by Minister of what? Finance. I thought, accounting officer, you would now be able to give us a breakdown. How much of that funding did not come?
The permanent secretary of the Minister of Public Service, Catherine Bitarakwate, was short of words to justify the failure to implement planned activities and asked for more time.
The nation is in the costing, which we did not provide the breakdown, but we'll provide it.
I asked in the first place, are we dealing with the right persons in regard? We started with Ajat, then we went to the other officer who literally failed to submit on her part. Honorable Chair, I want to move that the accounting officer is put on oath as she does respond to these other queries that we are yet to interrogate her on.
PAC also dispatched CID police attached to Parliament to retrieve documents pertaining financial records of the college.
Make sure the commissioner reports to CID tomorrow and you go to Jinja, collect all that file regarding NTR and bring it to the committee.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.